Welcome to the Auriga, our location for the fourth playthrough of Legendary Encounters. This is the fourth scenario, the fourth movie. This is Alien Resurrection. And this is the one I have the least experience with, and I think the one that is the hardest. So let's see how this turns out after my last success at Fiorina. We start, as usual, two characters, and as usual, on the right side, the medic. His roll card is already shuffled in here in his starting deck. And the second character will be a random character. I removed those I used in the last three playthroughs, just to have more variety, so we're definitely getting a new one, which is the priest. Thematically, he belongs into the third movie, but that's okay, we will take him. And he can only take 9 hits. And has a survival icon. And what can he do? He can spend attack points as recruit points. The left side is the priest. We have the sergeant deck. We have our four characters, Ripley, the cloned Ripley, Joner, Carl, and Christy. Let's shuffle those guys again. A bunch of wounds, the strike deck. Then there is the drone deck. And as usual, we're playing with two players, so there are two drone cards in each of the three hive decks. This is hive deck number 3. Hive deck number 2. Hive deck number 1. Let's fill up the headquarters. We have Ripley number 8. Wow, we have the Monster's Mother, a cost 9 card, a recruit 9 card. We have Call. We have just Calls and Ripley's. Well, that's okay for a start. And already ready to go. Our first objective, breakout. The objective is kill 3 xenomorph clones. And that's it. The priest starts with his first 6 cards in his hand. Unknown life form enters the ventilation shaft. We get a signal from the ventilation shaft. He has 2 attack points. There is nothing he can do with it. No scan nor aliens to kill. So he will go directly to recruit the 4 points. There are, in the fourth scenario, there are the mobilized cards. When you take them, they activate immediately their mobilize action, like the call card, mobilize, you may heal a strike for any player, which I don't want to do at the moment. So I could go for Ripley, look at any hidden card without revealing it to other players, which is not very much secret when you're playing two players solo, but I think I go for the secret mission card. It costs 4. It has a intel icon, so maybe the priest will also go for intel. Mobilize, you may scan any room. I will scan the only room with a signal, and it's an event. Let's see what this event does. They have escaped. If there are any enemies in the complex, nope, move them to the combat zone and add a hive card to the complex. The hive card is added even if there are no enemies in the complex. So that was kind of a lucky draw, and we get another card. The HQ fills up, and that's the first turn of the game. New card of hands. Wait a second, a new hand of cards. And the medic's turn. Let's shuffle it again and see what he gets. He has 2 attack points. Still nothing he can use at the moment. And 4 recruit points. He could go for the survival icons. Priest also has survival icons. He could go for Jonar, a coordinate card with 1 attack and 1 recruit point. But then he'd be only with 2 recruit points. I think he'll go for call card. Mobilize, you may heal a strike for any player. There's no strike to heal, so it's a wasted mobilize action. Headquarter fills up. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And back to the priest. Complex fills. The priest has 1, 2, 3 attack points, enough to scan the power station. And there is a noxious xenomorph. Reveal players have -1 health this turn, doesn't matter at the moment, and needs 4 attack to be killed. And we are at 3 recruit points, and I think he will recruit another intel card, the I can smell it card, a Ripley card that lets you look at a hidden card without revealing it to other players. Also the only cost 3 card in the headquarter. That would be awesome to get this monster card very early, but it costs 9. Maybe the priest with his special ability. The card says, once this card you may gain a dead alien. It loses its game text, and when you play it, it gets attack points equal to its strength. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. The medic's turn. Alien is moving. And he plays his medicine card, his battlefield medicine. He can draw a card and may heal a strike from any player. There's no strikes, fortunately, yet. 3 attack points, not enough to kill the xenomorph here. So another scan at the power station. That's a containment cell. Move this to operations. Pay 3 recruit points. If there's a xenomorph clone in the complex or in the combat zone, discard this and kill it. Oh yeah, I remember. The clones are pretty tough, but you can kill them by discarding the containment cell. Okay, that's the scan, and then 3 recruit points. We have another Ripley card with an intel, maybe let's leave it for the priest. Mobilize, choose a player to draw a card, and it needs attack icon. Choose a player to draw a card. Doesn't sound too interesting. I think I'll go for the Joner card, a strength card, which is a coordinate card. It costs 2, so 1 recruit point is wasted. There's another expensive, I'll just place it over there because they are the same. And that's the medic's turn. Back to the priest. Complex fills up another signal. The priest plays his roll card, draws another card, and now he can use all attack values as recruit points. He has the secret mission card, but it doesn't trigger because it only has he didn't play any intel. So he has 2, let's say he'll, okay, let's see what he has, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, he uses special abilities, so he has 7 recruit points, and I think that's good for grown in a lab. This card can actually clone a card you've already played this turn. Cool. Let's see how this works out. One, two, three, four, five, six. The medic. I think someone has to start killing some aliens. See what the medic can do. There's the Full of Surprise card, which doesn't trigger because we don't have a survival icon. There's 3 attack, not enough to kill the nauseous xenomorph. So for 3, the medic will just scan the power station, and there's our first hazard. No time to waste. To gain the hazard, and each time a player draws it, they immediately draw a strike and then put the hazard card back into any player's discard pile. Whoo! And 4 recruit points. Stupid. I could have recruited first. I have to get used to the mobilize action, because the mobilize would have got me 2 plus 2 attack. So in this scenario, just watch the order of your actions. Anyway, mobilize choose a player to draw a card. I think I will take this card. I will take the concealed pistol, mobilize, say you get plus 2 attack. Unfortunately, I already kind of wasted the 3 here, so I got 2, but for the 2 I can still scan the airlock. And this is one of the 3 xenomorph clones we have to kill, and you can see they have strength 10, so we're kind of lucky we have the containment cell here. Headquarter fills up. Medic. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Another 6 cards. The priest's turn. The complex fills up. And let's see what the priest can do. He can play I Can Smell It. Look at any hidden card without revealing it to the other players. So I'll just take this card here, and since I'm the only player, I will just reveal it. It's another clone, but it's not revealed. I just have a look at it. So this is a clone. Two attack, four attacks. That's great because four is enough to kill the nauseous xenomorph. Our first dead xenomorph, that was about time. And three recruit points. Why not go for another I can smell it card? Mobilize, choose player to draw a card. No, I just go for another of those. That's the priest's turn. One, two. Shuffle the deck. Three, four, five, six. The medic turns. The complex fills up. The clone still stays in the complex. The medic plays his roll card. He can draw another card. It's the sleep when you die man card. Gives us one attack plus another two attacks. That's three. Well, and for three, he'll scan the power station. There's the third clone. One, two, and we know the third. Oh, no. It moved, so I... Okay. Should have scanned the weapons locker. Just didn't. Didn't remember that. Okay, anyway, now it's face up. Four recruit points. Oh, this is face down. Let's see what we have here for four recruit points. There are some of these mobilized, choose a card to draw Christie cards, and there's another Ripley number 8 card. Two attack, and you get one attack for each other Ripley card you played this turn. Sounds interesting. And sounds more interesting than the other choices, so I'll take it for three, and one recruit point is wasted. One, two. Three, four, five, six. It's another awesome card here, costs 7, has 4 attacks, and scan any number of rooms one at a time. But now it's the priest's turn. The xenomorph clone moves into the combat zone. And he cannot kill it. But he can use the containment cell. I will place the secret mission card. It's only a 2 recruit points card, and you may scan any room, but only if there was an intel played before. I'll play the Grown in a Lab card, which copies exactly this card, so now I can scan a room, because this ability is triggered by the intel of the first card. I will scan a room. I want to find another containment cell. And I want to scan the most expensive room to scan. Containment cell. Great. One attack, pretty useless. But two, it's copied. Four, five, six, 7 recruit points. For 3, I'll obviously discard the containment cell and the xenomorph clone. clone, the first one. That was 3, so there are 4 left. And for 4, why not? There's only these 2 cards. I could go for a Sarge, or for both of these which would let the medic draw 2 cards, because there are 2 immobilizations. Let's see how this turns out. So, for 2, he takes the Christie card, play the Angels, mobilize, choose a player to draw a card. Medic will draw a card. And for another 2, he draws the same card again. Now he has some tech icons here. And he'll choose the medic again to draw another card. That's the priest's turn. The medic's turn. Another signal to the ventilation shaft. This one is pretty easy. It's 3 recruit points. Nothing to coordinate. There are not that many coordinate cards here. For 3, you'll scan the power station. And there's the 3rd containment cell. That's awesome if you have them early. If you have all the 3 clones in here with strength 10 each and no containment cell, this can be pretty devastating. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 recruit points. This shouts for Jonah. I mostly just hurt people. Choose a player. They may kill a card in their discard pile. That's an awesome ability for the hazard card. So I'll take it and mobilize it, and since there is no card to discard in the discard pile, I'll choose the priest to discard a card, and I think he'll just discard a grunt or a specialist. How about a grunt? That's the medic's turn. He draws a new hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then the priest's turn. Let's see what we have. Violence isn't the answer. He draws a card for his roll card. Then he has I can smell it. Look at any hidden card without revealing it. And again, I'll go for, oh, let's see what's here. Okay, that's the clone number 3. I'm not too scared of it right now because we have a containment cell. And let's see what's in here. That's a swimmer. It's one of the swimming aliens. If this alien is ever in a floated room, move it to the combat zone. And it has a strength of 5. I just push this down a bit to remind that I already know this card. Oh, why did I reveal the 2 cards? Because, I played 2 of the I Can Smell It cards. I was just ahead with this. So, let's see, we have 6 attack. I could use these recruit points as attack points. No, I could use the attack points as recruit points. That would be 6, 7, 8. That would be enough for Grown in the Lab, the card that lets you clone another card. Or the call card. I use the call card. Again, 6 plus 2 is 8, so I'll buy interface with father. One, two, three, four. Drop down the cards. Nervous priest. Five, six. The medic's turn. This card moves down. We already know that this is another clone. So I hope for another recruit point, because otherwise I wouldn't be possible to, wouldn't be able to kill him. His roll card, draw a card. There are our recruit points. Then I have new and improved, the Ripley card, which gets plus one attack for each other Ripley card played, no Ripley card played. I have a call and her ability triggers, you may heal a strike from any player. No strikes yet. So let's count attacks, four attacks. Four attacks lets me scan the ventilation shaft. That's a salivating xenomorph. Reveal. This alien is revealed in the combat zone. It has triple strike this turn. Wow, don't let this get into the combat zone. That's the four. Then I have four recruit points, and I'll use three of them to discard a containment cell together with our second xenomorph clone. That's two-thirds of objective one. And one recruit point is wasted, but that's okay. And now I expect to draw the hazard. Again, each time a player draws it, they immediately draw a strike card. A contaminated wound, one wound which cannot be healed, and then puts the hazard into any player's discard pile. That's interesting. Because now I would put it in the discard pile. If I put it in the discard pile, chances increase to draw it immediately again. So I think in this case I'll put it in the discard pile of priest. And hope to draw the card which lets me discard a card from the discard pile. One, two, three, four, five. Six, there is it. So great. The medic can discard the hazard card. Hopefully next time. The priest's turn. This card moves down. And it is an event. What does the event say? They've escaped. There are any enemies in the complex, move them to the combat zone. And add a hive card to the complex. This is very bad, because this guy in the combat zone deals triple strike. No! When you read exactly, it says, if this alien is revealed in the combat zone, it has triple strike. Okay, so I revealed it before in the complex, so no triple strike. Whoo! Three attack points. Nothing to coordinate here, nothing to hit for three, so that'll be another scan. Power station, and there's another xenomorph swimmer. time for 3 recruit points. Of course, he will discard the containment cell and kill the third xenomorph clone, which is our first objective, kill 3 xenomorph clones. Second objective, you're a thing, a construct setup. Put the top 3 characters from the barracks into the combat zone. And these are failed clones. They don't strike but can be fought. And their strength is equal to their cost, which is a lot. And with this 8 card, and when an event is drawn, draw a strike for each failed clone in the combat zone. So they only strike when an event is revealed. A lot to do here. That's almost the end of the priest's turn. This xenomorph strikes for a contaminated puncture. 3 hits that cannot be healed, and he can only take 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now we need some strength. The medic's turn. Complex fills still the xenomorph here. Let's see what the medic has. So he has these 2 cards. If I played this first, I could trigger this ability, and but I want to have it this way. No strength I can play it before, so no additional strength, only 2 recruit points, but I mostly just hurt people. Jonah's card, if a card with this scenario 4 icon is played before, choose a player, then they kill a card in their discard pile, and that would be, of course, the hazard. Then, that's 5 attack points. You will use 4 to kill the salivating xenomorph, and 1 is wasted. He has 2, 3, 4 recruit points. How about either another Christie strength card or a Ripley card, which gets stronger and stronger the more Ripley cards you play? So I guess I go for this card. It's the new and improved card. It's already in the deck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I really hope for the priest with his special ability to get 9 recruit points at a turn to get this monster card. We will find out. The priest's turn. Whatever this is, it moves down to the combat zone. And it is an event. Ah! That's tough. Because now each of these 3 failed clones strike. Nothing to prevent this. First strike is a double slash, which means draw another strike. Another double slash, draw another strike, no damage. So that was the first strike. Now the second one, it's an effect for the next turn. And the third one, it's 3. So he is at 8. One more strike and he is dead. It's that easy. This one I just keep here as a reminder. Now let's see what he can do. He can draw another card, plays his roll card, and draw another card. He can play... I can smell it. Another look at any hidden card. Let's go for this card. It's an event. Okay, we do not want to reveal this as long as these guys are in here. And a second one. Let's see what we have here. That's a flooded card. So if this is revealed, the room gets flooded. And enemies cannot be fought in this room. And for 5 recruit points, you can discard the card. You can drain it. Okay, so nothing we want to reveal at the moment. Then he has 6 attack. He could use, and 2 recruit points, he could use all his attack as recruit points. That would be 8. But I think it's more important to start some killing here. So for 6, he could either kill the swimmer or maybe go for the first card here. Yeah, for 5 he will kill the first, how is it called, failed clone, and that's his kill. 2 recruit points, he will recruit another, play the angels card, mobilize, choose a player to draw a card, that will be the medic, and headquarter fills up, and that's the end of the priest's turn, who is pretty close to dying. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I just put this card on top, the strike card, for the effect. And go for the medic's turn. Unfortunately, there is no heal card. That would be pretty urgent to heal some of the priest's wounds. This card moves down here. Flooding event. Now I try to remember my cards, and this is a swimmer. Which medic cannot kill because he only has 4 attack points and there's nothing to recruit. Sad, but for 4 he can at least kill one of the failed clones. He has 3 recruit points. No, okay, this time I will do this the right way. This time I will recruit first. For 3 I will recruit the concealed pistol, Christy, and mobilize to get +2 attack. So now I have 6 attack. Better. And I will kill the swimmer instead. Still learning here. Now 3 recruit points. Once this turn, if the weapons locker is clear, you get +2 attack. That's nice, and that's the only card that costs 3. I'm not sure. I could also go for a Sarge. Yeah, why not? The medic will buy a Sarge, and that's an Intel Sarge. Okay, I'll take it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The priest's turn at He has a damaged hand at the start of your turn. Discard this and two random cards from your hand. So let's shuffle his hand. Draw one card, a specialist, two cards, a Christie card. So he starts his turn with only four cards. The swimmer is moved down. And he cannot afford to take another wound, another strike card. He can take a strike card, but it has to be a zero wound card. Now, yes, that's great. He will play the call card, which has four attack points. And it says, scan any number of rooms one at a time. No. I cannot afford to scan. If it's another event card, I know this one is one, then he will take a wound immediately. Two, he would have to draw two strike cards. So no, I will not scan. But I will copy the card with the Ripley card. So this is eight attack. And then I'll play the secret mission. I could also scan a room. I don't want to scan at the moment. And this is eight attacks. So five to kill the swimmer. And three are unfortunately wasted. Then three recruit points for the Jonah card, the incinerated flame. We still need to get rid of those failed clones. It was bad luck I drew the high card here. Let's see what's in the combat zone. Ooh, the salivating xenomorph, and now the reveal effect triggers. If this alien is revealed in the combat zone, it has triple strike this turn. We do not want to have that. But at the moment, the medic doesn't have enough attack points. Let's see how this turns out. The medic plays his medicine card. He draws another card and he can heal a strike from any player, which is of course the three wound strike from the priest. Then he will play call, you may heal a strike from any player, which is another wound from the priest. And then the Ripley card for two attack, plus one attack per Ripley card played in this turn. He didn't play any Ripley cards. So this is unfortunately only two attacks. Not enough to kill the xenomorph, which will deal three strike cards next end of the turn. Wow. And now I will scan this room. This is the flooding. And just stays there and can be removed by five recruit points. Da, da, da. I'm doing this because now the event card is moved on it. Well, let's see, maybe we just remove it anyway right now. Recruit points, six recruit points. Now I think it's more important to kill another of the failed clones for four recruit points, and for two, let's get another of the Jonah cards here. And that's almost the medic's turn. Now, the nasty salivating xenomorph strikes three times. Medic can take 10 wounds, he already has one. First is contaminated gash, two wounds that cannot be healed. The second one is close call, no strike, and the third one is deep gash, two wounds. Okay. Still alive. 4, 5, 6. Now, the priest's turn, both cards move down here. There's the event card. Then he plays his roll card to draw another card. He plays the I can smell it Ripley card. Look at any hidden card without revealing it to other players. Again, I'll just go for ventilation shaft. It's a cornered scientist. The strength of 3. The alien has a strength of 3. Then the Christie card, which does not trigger, and then he has 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 attack, which is enough to kill this beast here. 2 attack left, so he will scan this room. That's a second hazard. And the second hazard says, we have to work together. The players may show any of their cards. For each class that isn't shown, add a hive card to the complex. Whew! Okay, we have 5 classes. And we have revealed survival, intel, tech, and strength. That's awesome. So what's missing, actually leadership is missing, so for the one missing, how is it called here, class, a card is added. Okay. 1 recruit point, the medic could coordinate another 2. Why not? Why not? We coordinate the Sarge. Now the priest has 3 recruit points. I'm thinking of either buying another of those Ripley cards or a Sarge. He'll buy another Ripley card, another I can smell it card. That's the priest's turn. No strikes this time. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The medic turn. Now we know what's going to happen because this is an event card. And it still says event, absolute horror, draw a strike for each failed clone in the combat zone. So this is another strike. And it's a 0 damage strike. But you're lucky, guy. The medic will play the Jonah card. The medic will play the Christie card. And now it triggers because the Jonah card has a strength icon, and the strength icon says that this card has another 2 attack. So we are at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 attack. Nothing to coordinate. And if I remember right, we had a strength 3 alien here. So for 3, I will scan the room, and for another 3, I just kill the alien that's cornering the scientist. And he's so thankful. Choose any number of players to each draw a card. So the priest will draw a card, and of course the medic will draw a card. It's another grunt for another attack point, useless at the moment. And now he has 4 recruit points, and he'll take another of the call heal cards. Looks like we need, now this doesn't need to be shifted, looks like we have to heal a lot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. priest's turn. He has tons of these I can smell it Ripley cards to look at a hidden card without revealing it. This one will move into the flooded room next time. Well, I was scanned the ventilation shaft. It's another swimmer. That's a swimmer. Then the Christie card. The Christie card does not trigger. That's four attack. Nothing to coordinate. For four attack, he will skin the power station, and that's another salivating xenomorph. And then he has 1, 2, 3, 4 recruit points. Only cheap stuff in here. Another Christie card. Yeah, maybe one day he'll have enough in his deck to trigger each other. So for 2 he'll pay. He will buy or recruit the Christie card. And for another 2 he could go for, why not, a coordinate Jonah card. Better than nothing. That's his turn. We still have to get rid of the strength 8 failed clone. Almost only starting characters. Okay, the medic's turn. Cards move over here. Another signal in the ventilation shaft. Let's see what we have. We have new and improved, the Ripley card for 2 attack. Then the Joner card, which now triggers, and choose any player to kill a card in that is card pile. I'm going to kill a cheap, let's say a cheap, I go for a specialist this time, and then I can play the Christie card, which triggers because of the strength icon, and that's now strength 2. So, in total, 2 plus 3 is 5, plus 2 is 7, plus 1 is 8. 8 is enough to kill the last failed clone. That's great. And then 4 recruit points. Let's go for another healing card. Priest's turn. Whatever this is, it moves into the combat zone. And it is flooded. It's another flooded room, and if it's revealed in the combat zone, instead it is attached to the leftmost room in the complex that isn't flooded, which means this room is flooded, and this enemy cannot be fought in here. I see. Let's see what we have here. 3 attack. Ok, Okay, let's do some planning here. This one will move over to this flooded room. So if I can remove the flooding here, the priest can remove the flooding here, the medic could kill him here. But we don't know what will move into the combat zone. But that still sounds like a plan. So the medic will coordinate... Oh, even better, right. The medic will coordinate a sarge for 2 recruit points plus 3 is 5, and for 5 drain this room. Let's draw the card. Also, he provides an attack icon, and now I can play the Christie's card, which says draw a card. Choose a player to draw a card. And now, if I choose the priest and he draws another strike, another attack, sorry, he could kill the xenomorph immediately. But if it's anything else, it might be useless. So I'll choose the medic to draw another card. Okay. You keep throwing cards today. That's the end of the priest's turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. On the medic's turn, this card will move down here and the complex fills up. Let's hope for a harmless card here. Something like a facehugger. Okay, I see. By the way, I think we completed the objective. Setup. Put the top 3 characters. They don't strike. Objective. Kill the failed clones. I killed the failed clones. So, the objective is completed. Now we have objective 3. Shield breed. You'll die. Kill the clone queen and the newborn. So, now... The medic has a facehugger right in its face, in his face. Let's first play the medicine card to draw another card. And heal a wound from a player. I will heal, he can take 6 more and he can take 5 more. Let's heal him first. Then I'll play Full of Surprises. Call card that triggers. You may heal a strike from any player. Now I heal this card. All healable strikes are healed. The Ripley card and Jonah card. Let's count the attack points. That's 4 attack points, nothing to coordinate, so for 3. No, it doesn't matter. I thought about killing this one first, but I see the priest has enough strength, enough attack to kill it by himself. So for 3 points, he'll kill the nasty facehugger. And 1 is kind of wasted. Recruit points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 recruit points. I definitely want to have one of those awesome Ripley cards that lets you copy another card. That's the medic's turn. Looking better right now. But the game is not over yet. Priest's turn. Salivating Xenomorph moves down. He does not do his triple strike because he wasn't revealed in the combat zone. Now, the priest plays his roll card and draws another card. I don't have and lots of cards to scan rooms. Let's see what happens if I draw an event. Kill the leftmost character in the headquarter and put the event card in its space. Okay, it reduces the amount of cards in the headquarter. So I'm not too scared about that. Would be sad to lose this other cost 6 card, but I think that's okay. Let's go for the Ripley card. Look at any hidden card without revealing it. Oh, that's a good combination. So I will look at this card. It's a clone facehugger. Reveal, put this in front of you. Ouch, it's a facehugger with strength 5. Okay, so this is a card I do not want to actually scan. Then I'll play the call card, which lets me scan any number of cards in any number of rooms, one at a time. Now I'm a bit scared. But even if he draws one of those facehuggers, he can kill it immediately, but then he couldn't kill this xenomorph. So let's take the opportunity and start scanning. I want to scan this card, which is the cloned queen. One of our objectives. Strength 11, and in the combat zone at the start of each player's turn after the hive card has been added, add an extra hive card. Okay, don't want to have this in the combat zone. I'll scan the next room. That's a xenomorph spitter. Ouch! Reveal. Draw a strike. So the priest will draw a strike. Ouch! For 5 wounds. So he's at 8. And this is the time where he will stop scanning. Now he has 7 attack points. 4 to kill the salivating xenomorph. And for another 2 he will not scan again. Just in case there are more of those spitters, and I expect there to be more. I don't know the decks by heart at the moment. 3 recruit points, something to recruit. Well, a Jonah card, 2 attack. Why not? Let's take it. And we really have to get rid of this 5 wounds strike card. 5, 6. And it's the medic's turn. Okay, that's the nasty facehugger. One of the nasties, I guess. Let's see what we have in the combat zone. It's another swimmer with a strength 5. I do have strength 5. Could have more, or I can use the kill a card in the discard pile. Depending on the order I play this, 2 cards. 2, 4, 5, 6. I guess I'll do it like this. I'll play the concealed pistol first, only for the recruit points and for the strength icon, and the strength icon. They don't have any names, the icons for the scenarios. The scenario icon, choose a player, then they kill a card in their discard pile. And the medic kills another specialist. So this is a total of 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 attack. 5 to kill the swimmer. And 2 to scan the airlock. That's an event. Okay, the event says kill the leftmost character in the headquarter. And now the event is placed here and just blocks the space. I can live with that. That's the medic's turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cards. No coordinate card here. The priest's turn. This xenomorph moves over here. The queen moves over there. And there's a clone card. There's a draw card. There's a scan any room card. He really doesn't want to scan anything. But he can clone this Ripley card to get 7 strength to kill the spitter. Okay, he will play Ripley. Look at any hidden cards without revealing it to other players. That's the xenomorph. This one, did we scan that? Did we look at this? I just forgot. That's the facehugger. Okay. That's the facehugger. I will copy that card and look at another hidden card. That's just a meddlesome xenomorph. Strength 4. And I think I already had a look at this card, but I have to admit, I forgot. Too many things to concentrate here. So, the strength 2 is copied, now it's 4, 5, 6, 7 strength, 7 attack against the strength 7. This xenomorph is toast, and 2 recruit points, nothing to coordinate, nothing to recruit for 2, so that's it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Six. The medic's turn. The cloned queen moves closer. That's the facehugger. That's the strength 4 guy. And let's see what we have here. Great, 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 great. That's the Ripley card for 2 attack, and it has a survival icon, which means that this card, the call card, triggers. You may heal a strike from any player. Woo, let's get rid of this. 5 wounds. The Christie card does not trigger. And now this is only 2 attack. Okay, let's see, let's make a plan here. If I use the 2 to reveal the facehugger, we'll right jump into the medic's face, but then the priest will have enough attack points to kill it. So I think this has to be done. For the 2, he'll scan the flooded room. It also has the advantage that the clone will not be pushed out. That's a cloned facehugger. Put this in front of you. Any player can fight it on their turn if it's still alive at the end of your next turn. So 2 turns to go. Okay, it just stays here. And now recruit points. 6, 7 recruit points. What's the most expensive card? 5, mobilize. On this turn you may gain a sergeant or character from the headquarters that costs 3 or less. That's okay. Another heal card. Actually, I really want to have more strength cards. These are only recruit point cards. So I go for the Christie card. And I can gain a sarge or a character that costs 3 or less. And I will take the Christie character here. The medic's turn. 1, 2. He's fighting with a facehugger. Three, four, five, six. That's the priest's turn. This moves down here, this moves over here, this moves over here. And the priest should use at least 5 attack to kill this facehugger. But first, let's see what we have here. The weapon locker is cleared, you get +2 attack. The weapon locker is here. I don't know if I want to risk it. So first of all, I play the Flamer for 2 attack. Then I play Christie. His ability triggers because of the tech icon. He can choose a player to draw a card. Do I want to be that player? Does the priest wants to be the player? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. No, I think the medic will draw another card. That's this card. Then we have secret mission card. The effect does not trigger. I cannot scan another room. And the Ripley card. Look at any hidden card without revealing it to other players. I want to do that. And I'm gonna scan. I want to look at this card. That's another event. Okay, event. Okay. Then let's count attack points. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's all? That's all. He could coordinate 1. Then I could scan the flooded room, but we already know what's in there. So no coordinating for 5 of the 6 points. He will kill the cloned facehugger. And the medic is safe again. Then 4 recruit points for... for another of the call cards. One, two, three, four, five, six. That's the end of the priest's turn and the start of the medic's turn. The start of the medic's turn, unfortunately, the cloned queen will move down. These cards move over. And since the clone queen is now in the combat zone, another card is added to the hive. Wow! And this is the newborn. Whew, triple strike. These are our 2 objectives. Triple strike in the combat zone, pay 6 recruit points and show a Ripley card, and the new one doesn't strike this turn. You may have it kill a different enemy in the combat zone. Wow. And don't want to be a rules lawyer here, but it says kill a different enemy in the combat zone, and the clone queen is an enemy. And that would fit thematically, because in the movie he's also killing his mother. So actually, 6 recruit points, a Ripley card, and he'll kill the clone queen. Awesome. But it needs 13 attack. 13 attack! To kill it. How the hell? Let's see. Let's see what we can do about it. I'll start with easy Jonah card. Here we don't have any coordinate cards. I will go on with a Christie card without any effect. I'll play a heal card which does not trigger, but the second heal card triggers. But anyway, there's nothing I can heal because they are all wounds that cannot be healed. But this card triggers and now has two attack. Yeah. Just for the record, we would have our six recruit points, but no Ripley card. So the medic will get a triple strike. And one from the clone queen. Okay, let's start calming attacks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6 attack points. And that is a scan for 2. Right, we knew that. And another 4 for a total of 6 to kill this one. And it says, on death, you may scan a room, and I will scan a room, I will scan this room, draw a strike. Damn spitters. I do have a feeling the medic will gonna die. Oh, that's a facehugger. That's a facehugger. So, now he can recruit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. For 8 he can recruit he will recruit, no, not the call card. I just expect him to die, so I don't want to buy cards that the priest maybe wants to have, so for 8 I will recruit another Jonah. That's 2. Plus 3 is 5. Yeah, we don't need another one of these. Plus 2, 7. Okay. And now it's the end of the medic's turn and he takes 1 strike from the queen. The next player also draws a strike, it's 1 wound, and the next player draws a strike, that's 2 wounds, and then 3 from the newborn. 1, that's a double slash, draw another strike, no damage. He's at 5. The second of the triple strike, a 1 that cannot be healed, hey, he may survive. And the third one, that's 2 hits. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Wow. I told you this is a tough scenario. 4, 5, 6. Now I would need the roll card, the priest's roll card, but it's not there. So the face hugger is on the medic. Let's see, the priest's turn. This card moves over here. That's the event. This moves over there. Still those beasts there. I do have a clone card. So I'll play the Christie card first. I'll play another Christie card. Now this is triggered. Choose a player to draw a card. And he will he has to kill this facehugger. He will draw another card, of course. Then he will clone the card. It's So we will draw another card. And that's all I can do. Look at any hidden card without revealing it. Aha, another of those cloned face huggers. So now he has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 attack. 3 he needs to use to kill the facehugger. And he will use another 2 to scan the room with the event card. It's placed here. And he has 3 recruit points and nothing to recruit for 3, and he doesn't want to recruit a sarge, so he doesn't recruit. Now he's the next one to draw 4 strikes. 1 from the queen, 1 hit, he's at 6, he can take 9. Then the first from the newborn, another hit. Second from the newborn, 4 hits. But when you draw this, any other player may show a survival icon, only show character to cancel it. And I have, the medic has a survival icon card, so this is cancelled. And the third hit is an effect. Whoa, 5, 6, 7. Another lucky draw. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, damn, I need the roll card. The broken morale triggers next time. The medic's turn. The medic's turn. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, awesome. The medic's turn starts like this. Then he has 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 recruit and he'll spend them and show the Ripley card, and the newborn will not attack, doesn't strike this turn. You may have a kill a different enemy in the combat zone, kills his mother. 1/2 of the last objective. And then there's another 2 attack points, and he doesn't want to scan because he might discover another spitter. He used up his recruit points, so that's his turn, and the newborn doesn't strike. 5, 6. Still don't know how to get the 13 attack points. The priest's turn. This card moves down. And now, wait a second, at the start of your turn, this triggers first. That's the broken morale, and all starting characters are removed, are discarded, that's only these 2. Let's see what we have in the combat zone. Another event. Okay. So the headquarters is getting smaller and smaller. And now, two plus, that's another face hugger. Ooh, that's a lot to think about. Because I have Jonah here, the flamer. If the weapons locker is clear, you get +2 attack. So that would be 4, and I could scan the room for free. That's 4, 8. This Then 10, 11, and this card would let me draw another card. If this will be anything with 2 attack, the new one will be killed. It could kill the new one. And I'm not scared of the facehugger because medic has enough to kill the facehugger. Okay, so let's see what we draw first. I play the flamer. I'll play the Christie card, which now triggers, and the priest draws another card. Okay, that's his roll card. You draw another card. And that's only a stupid little specialist. Still, should I stick with the plan? Okay, this one's not worth it. So that would be like 11. Yeah, okay. I will stick with the plan. I will play Ripley. I can smell it. Look at any hidden card. I will look at this hidden card. Another facehugger. So that's 2 facehuggers. Now we go like this, and then we die. That's bad. On the other hand, I could spend, now I can convert the attack to recruit points and calm the newborn down, which would let me survive, which is also a big deal. Okay. Facehugger, facehugger. I scan any number of rooms. I'll scan this room. This is a clone facehugger. Then this card, because the weapons locker is empty, now has 4 attack. So I will have 4, 5, 6, 7, 11. 6 of those. Okay, let's do this in order. These are 4 attack, 5 attack. And they are converted, I convert them with his special ability to recruit points, plus 1 recruit points, that's 6 recruit points, and I do have a Ripley card, so the newborn is tamed, calmed down for the moment. That's this part, then I have 4 attack points and kill the facehugger. 6 attack points and kill this facehugger for 5. Okay, this kind of somehow worked out. One, two, three. He doesn't strike. Four, five, six. The priest's turn, those cards move down, this is another facehugger, and let's see what we can do here. 4, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 with a coordinate. Oh come on, it's so close. If I would play them in this order, the card effect would trigger, it would be 2. So that's 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. What did I do here? Okay, I just miscalculated it. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, not close to 30. This one cannot be fought at the moment. For 10, or for 9, for 8 I could reveal this card and kill the facehugger immediately. And then I'll have to draw 3 strikes and die. But I cannot prevent this. I don't know how to get 6 recruit points We can only coordinate one recruit point. Three, four. Okay, so I play this, the cards in this order. First, the Jonah card for 3 points, attack points. He triggers the Christie card for another 2, that's 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. For 3, he'll scan this room. There's the facehugger. For 5, he'll kill the facehugger immediately. And the 1 is wasted. He has 2 recruit points. His turn is almost over. The newborn strikes 3 times. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Another 2 hits and he dies. First strike, 1 hit. Second strike, 2 hits. The medic is dead. Killed by the newborn. Now let's hope for the priest. The priest's turn starts. Card moves down here. And 5, 6, 7 can only take 2 more hits. And he don't have any healing abilities in his deck. That's the downside of specializing the characters. He has 3 attack, he has a copy card. Who needs a copy card? Scan any room. I don't want to scan, I don't want to find another spitter. 2, 3, 4, haha, okay, here we go. I will clone this card. Now I have 2 recruit points and another 2. That's 5, 6, and I do have a Ripley card. So the newborn does not attack. Then I have 3 attack. And yeah, as I said before, I don't want to scan. It's risky to scan. If there's another spitter in there, I'd have to draw immediately. On the other hand, this one gets pushed down anyway. I don't know. I take the risk, I'll scan. Everybody's shouting, no, don't do it! I will do it. I'll scan this, the weapons room, the weapons locker. It's a xenomorph spitter. 5, 6, 7. He can take 3 more hits. 3. Now he can take 2 more hits and draw 3. Sorry for all of you screaming not to scan. That was just curiosity. Curiosity killed the priest. So I think I came on the one hand pretty far, but on the other hand, getting 30 attack points is pretty much. Maybe next time I have to go for more. There weren't a lot of coordinate strength cards, so maybe more of the clone cards, whatever, but this one I'll definitely have to play again, and maybe I just let the camera set up and record it. Hope you had fun anyway, I think it was very exciting, and see you next time. Bye!